Hey you guys, I'm Sarah Arrington with Deer Meat for Dinner. This is my first Osceola turkey I've ever shot, so now we're gonna clean them, then we're gonna cook them. I mean, it can't get any better than that.
Nice shot.
That was the most awesome turkey hunt I've ever been on. You guys, they were gobbling all morning. Oh, now I'm shaking really bad. They were gobbling all morning long. And I'm looking this way because I'm hearing them that way. And all of a sudden, one flies in. I'm sitting right there, you guys. Right there, I'm sitting. And I tried to cover up my face with mud once they start gobbling because I realized we're right on top of them. So then one flew in right here. And I'm like, oh, crap. So then I'm getting ready for like this bush. Then I look over and there's a pile of them under that feeder. I'm like, where'd they all come from? And then they just started piling in like one after one after one. Then this tom just flew in and he started fanning. But I had to wait till he stopped fanning so I could get a good shot. This is my first Osceola.
Now, I want you guys to know that that feeder has no corn in it. It is totally like non-functional. This is just a food plot. Yeah. Awesome. Give me some skin, baby.
Oh. I probably smell like spit because I've been spitting my face now.
Awesome stuff right here.
Oh my god. I'm so good. That was perfect.
Perfect shot, baby.
Oh my god. That's so awesome.
Look at that. Nice bird. Nice big beard. Oh, yeah. Oh, I thought it was a double beard. Nice big long beard.
I wasn't about to wait. Here, just let him die.
Look at this bird, y'all. He's dead, honey. You killed him stone dead. She was set up right there. I was set up back here. Now I had a decoy back here with me that if...
Did you use it?
I never used it. I was going to wait if he started working out here to go away from us, then I was going to use
it. First Osceola turkey in the books.
I just wanted y'all to see real quick that this is a completely non-functioning feeder. This is where they're flying in.
All right, you guys, sorry about the mower in the background. We're back at the house. We've got a little Aria here, my mom, and we're gonna clean this bird. I'm gonna show you real quick what we do. The spurs on an Osceola are what are really impressive.
They have a ton of tendons in their legs, so you gotta cut that tendon just right.
First thing we need are our feet. Then we're gonna remove the beard. To remove a beard, all you wanna do is reach down and grab it right at the base. Not skin, just the base. Pull your fingers around it here and just pull it right out. The whole thing will come out just perfect. There's your beard. There's his anus. We'll go right above that. Take a nice sharp knife. There you go. That's what I'm looking for right there. And then we're gonna come in here. Now, on an Osceola turkey, the most identifying characteristic is the black in the flight feathers. These are called flight feathers, and you can see he's been strutting, or as Sarah would call it, fanning.
Same difference.
He brooms them off, but that's the mark of a true Osceola. I'll tell you what else you can do. If you don't want to use the wings in your mount, you can salt them, and then when they're nice and stiff, you can use them as when you do your fly down cackle to imitate another bird flying out of the tree. You can salt your wings and make a really realistic fly down cackle with the sound of wings. You got your spurs and your feet, your wings, your fan, and your beard. All right, and now Sarah's gonna show you how her and her dad breast out a turkey.
Okay, Dad and I always pluck our bird, and Rob said he doesn't, but I'm just gonna do a little bit and show you what we do. Okay, now you can see what you're doing without the feathers, but this, let me just wait. The dogs are working. I'll just wait. And when you pluck, you want to grab a couple at a time, because if you grab a whole handful, that's what it does, which is not a big deal, but. So anyway, Dad and I just break the skin. Open it up. So now I'm staring at the meat. And you can just peel that right on back. But when the feathers get wet, they get all sticky. So it's nice to have just the feathers gone, because then you have to deal with feathers, wet feathers.
That's actually, that right there is what he uses to gobble. That air sac, yeah.
Okay.
Beautiful, nice big breast.
And with the feathers gone, yeah, it's sticky and they're messy, but you really don't have many feathers on your breast, and it's easy to clean. And Dad and I always breasted out our birds. We never use the turkey legs because they're so tough from running all the time. So Rob is now gonna clean the turkey legs and show us how we can maybe slow roast or do something with the legs so we can use more of the meat.
All right, so you guys have to admit, Sarah did a great job breasting that bird out. I mean, she hasn't cleaned the turkey in 4 or 5 years, and she just whipped right through that. Now what I'm gonna do is, I'm just gonna come in here. I see so many people that all they use are the breast. They just breast the bird out, and that's the end of it. I like dark meat. Well, why leave all that wonderful dark meat on the bird? Cut the breast off.
Cut the leg off?
Yeah, well, you cut the leg off, cut the whole thigh. Pull that down, like, and look at that. Big old beautiful thigh. Two thighs,
two breasts, wings, fan, feet, and a beard. We'll take one of the wings and lay the fan nice and closed up right inside there. Then we'll take the 2 feet, lay them in there with the beard, put the other wing over top of it, and then I'll take Saran wrap, be nice and good, so when we take it to the taxidermist, it's perfect. Now let's go cook them. Okay, you guys, we are back at camp. Still the same day. I iced it down real nice at the house. Check that out. Pretty stuff right there, y'all. All right, who is ready to cook some turkey? This guy. We've got turkey meat, squash, zucchini, sweet peppers, baby Bella mushrooms, white mushrooms, and some center cut applewood smoked bacon. Watch what happens next.
How many of y'all have had that problem before? My GoPro is full.
Total fail.
Here's my turkey breasts. Those are the turkey tenderloins. I'm gonna cut these up into bite-sized chunks, season them with Everglades fish and chicken, wrap them in applewood smoked bacon, and then I'm gonna create shish kebabs with diced up zucchini, squash, mushrooms, peppers, bacon.
Look at that, you guys.
Hashtag boom, look at that, beauties. Finish it off with just a little bit of Everglades fish and chicken. Somebody stop me.
This is what I actually wanted to come out here and talk to you guys about. So many of you have been asking me for how-tos and beginners. Now, this morning was a quick hunt. We got out there. We were right in the heart of them. We got in under the cover of darkness. I had a good idea where they were roosted, and I figured they were gonna go one of two directions. I didn't start calling. I didn't start talking. I didn't start trying to wake the birds up. I let the birds wake up on their own. Now, there's a good reason for doing that. Those birds live out there every single day. They evade predators every single day, and a lot of birds evade hunters every single day. So the best thing you can do is blend into their natural environment the best you can without ever saying a word. Now,
let's look at this. These are all tools. That's a tool. These are tools. That's a tool. That's a tool.
They're all tools. Tools are like tools in your closet or in your workbench. Let's say you went out and spent a whole lot of money on a hammer or a socket set or a screwdriver set, but the job you were doing didn't call for a sledgehammer. Maybe it called for a small Phillips head screwdriver. Well, no matter how much you paid for that sledgehammer, it wouldn't do the job correctly. So you gotta use the proper tools. Today, when we got in there, right off the bat, we waited. Once I heard they were talking, they were literally due west of us. I'm like, okay, they're either gonna fly down to the west or they're gonna fly down to the north of us or fly down to the south of us. I didn't wanna start talking. I had my decoy actually sitting behind me in the palmettos. Now, let's say the birds would have flew down and then started working away from us. Well, at that time, I already had a stake in the ground. I would have just taken the decoy, I would have put it out there, and then I actually had a little stick that I could have poked the decoy to make it move and make it look like it was strutting. I had my call. So let's say they were going away, or let's say that Tom heard another hen yelping off in the distance and started heading that way, then I would start firing up. I'd start firing up and I'd put that decoy out there and I'd try to get him coming back this way. But this morning it didn't happen like that. We had a hen fly down right next to us. We had hens fly down at the end of the food plot. There were hens all over the place. And I thought the best tool I could use was zip it. So if you find yourselves out in the woods, just because you went out and spent a lot of money on a really nice decoy and dried your fan out last year, and you have all your calls that you've been practicing with, you know, for the last year or 5 years, it doesn't mean you have to use them just because you're proficient with them and they're a great tool. A great tool is not always the correct tool. I urge you, I am not familiar with any other turkey than these Osceolas, but the least you can say with an Osceola, the better you will be. Many, many times, because the woods are so thick here, they'll gobble and strut up and down a limb. When they hit the ground, they zip it. They already know where the hens are that they want to go see. They already know what they want to go do. If you keep talking, all you're gonna do is drive them away. So I hope that helped you out just a little bit. And I gotta say one more thing, and you guys are gonna think I'm just pushing a product, but I'm not. This gun right here.
That right there is an Escort 12 gauge. Straight out of the box, factory as it can be. We were shooting the cheapest number 4 lead shot you can imagine.
And at 42 yards, Sarah knocked the sucker slap out of that gobbler's mouth. That's an awesome gun.
Woo. Look at that, y'all. That's a work of art. Oh my goodness. Take that just like that. I'm gonna start lathering some mopping sauce on there, just like that.
Woo. So now the heat in the center is turned off. A little bit of heat on both sides. We'll just let that slow cook until mama gets here.
Look who just showed up, you guys. Here she is. The myth, the legend, Sarah Ant.
Say hi!
Oh my goodness, hi!
Say hi!
You're so cute!
Hi! Wave to her.
Hey, hey! How you doing? Okay. Ooh. Take a look.
Is it too hot for her to open? Shish kebabs! Yeah, I love shish kebabs. That's such a good idea.
Yeah. Lord, thank you for this wonderful day. Thank you for all this wonderful food. Lord, thank you for that turkey this morning. Lord, I pray that you keep us safe throughout the week. Help me have a nice trip down to Costa Rica, Lord. Please be with us and forgive us of all of our sins. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, let's see what you think.
I was like, I want to try some. Here, hold on, let me cut first. Okay, this is all we got for knives. Oh, it's so perfect. Wow. Smells good. How'd you season it?
I used the fish and chicken and mopping sauce.
Mmm. That's like the best turkey I've ever had. No joke.
Yeah, you say that because you shot it.
Well, that too, but it seriously is super, super good. The bacon, mmm.
And then you can dip a little bit in there. That's what I mopped on it.
Oh, you put the, I don't want a lot. I just want to dip. It doesn't even need that. It's no. So good. I mean, it's good. It's good. You want to try some?
Hey, what are you doing over there?
Turkey? Here. You like it? It's turkey. A turkey.
Okay, so she didn't spit it out. And this is what we do. We give her all the food that we eat, and she likes what she likes, but she likes everything. Okay, so to all the cooks out there, have you ever cooked something and, like, you're just so tired that you're not even hungry? That's how I am right now. I'm literally worn slap out. So try the mushrooms and everything and see what you think.
I just tried the squash. The squash is really good. We'll just empty the plate. Yeah. I'm thinking that too. Mushrooms, great. Pepper's great.
She's pregnant and she's hungry. She could, she'd chew on this table and say it was great.
No, it's really good. It's cooked perfectly.
Okay, so you killed the turkey this morning. Is the turkey real tough?
No, and it doesn't taste gay. It doesn't taste like turkey. It obviously tastes like turkey, but not wild turkey. Like, the reason I said that their legs are tough is because they're wild birds. They're constantly running. They're constantly moving. Turkey that you buy in the store is farm-raised turkey. They just sit around and don't do anything. That's why they're plump. That's why they're not tough and moist. But this bird, I've never tasted such an amazing
wild turkey.
It is so good. Cliff's gonna like me for saying wild turkey, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
Wild turkey.
All right, y'all. I'm going home to edit, and I got 11:50 p.m. flight tonight. Love you.
And we go.